so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. I came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. I felt a little fear upon my back. I said, don't look back, just keep on walking.
Live session on the beat, Katie Tunstall and Black Horse and a Cherry Tree. My goodness. It was worth scrambling around on the floor for, wasn't it, plugging leads in?
Oh, I'm used to that.
It's almost unbelievable. Unless anyone's actually seen you performing that, it's almost unbelievable to think that that is you standing there on your own doing it. And, people can only take our word for that. But it was.
It was. Me and the pedal. Entirely alone, with the little pedal helping me along.
How did you learn, or where did you get the idea from to do that?
I'd seen a Canadian artist called Son of Dave, who's this really weird sort of... The only way to describe him is a ginger nylon 80s Elvis. He's like a kind of really quirky art house style guy, and he gets up on stage with a huge pair of aviator shades on and basically goes up with no guitar or anything, has a harmonica, a shaker, and he beatboxes. And I saw him doing this with this loop pedal, and I don't know what pedal he had in particular, but basically it was just this amazing show on his own. And he'd be putting in sort of and then his little harmonica, and then you're going, leading at a crossroads. And he'd just be doing this amazing blues stuff. And it kind of planted the seed, really. And then I saw Jim White supporting David Byrne down in London, and he, again, was using this loop pedal. And I'd made the album, and I was looking at a summer of gigs with just my guitar, and it just was such a dull prospect that I decided to get the pedal so I could kind of present the songs the way I thought they should sound.
It looks so intuitive the way you do it now. Did that take a lot of working out to get it to that situation?
Honestly, not much. It's one, if you see someone doing it, it's the best lesson, because you go, oh God, that's so easy. And then you just, I mean, the most difficult thing is just trusting that you're going to get the timing right, because if you don't do that, then it sounds hideous.
There was a wonderful moment a few months ago where I was at home on a Friday night, and we'd got Jules Holland on, and you appeared on the screen, and I'd kind of only been paying half attention until you appeared and started doing this very clever thing. And I sat and watched it, and during the course of you performing, my phone never stopped bleeping. There's text message after text message after text message coming in. I thought, what's going on here? And then I looked at my phone, and everybody said, Jules Holland now. I mean, was that a turning point?
I think so, yeah, definitely. I mean, especially looking back, these things are often, you know, they have more clarity with hindsight, but I'd find out that Naz's father, Naz the rapper, his father had caught a cold and couldn't do the spot that they'd been offered. And so I was called about 24 hours beforehand and asked if I wanted to come. I was in Sheffield, actually, playing with my friend's band, Half Cousin. We were on tour with the Earlies on a tour bus going around Britain. And the record company had said, you might have to come back to London if something important comes up. I was like, ah, well, yeah, nothing will come up. And of course it did. And so I didn't have time to think about it, thank God. You know, I didn't dwell on it, didn't analyse it, just went on and did it. And I think I probably did do one of the best performances of it I've ever done.
Well,
I obviously work well under pressure.
And the track Black Horse and the Cherry Tree, there's something about that as well. There's just something, it's got that certain je ne sais quoi that makes it irresistible. What do you think it is?
Well, it's slightly different from my usual approach to songs, particularly this album, Eye to the Telescope, because all the songs, the theme is that they're all very intimate. I call them kitchen table songs. It's just basically sitting down with one person or a particular incident in a relationship, or, you know, it's very personal. And Black Horse and the Cherry Tree is kind of a bit more conceptual. It's just basically a song about good and evil and the internal struggle that one sometimes encounters.
And Eye to the Telescope, it's a cracking album.
It's
one of the best things of the year. Well, it was towards the end of last year, wasn't it,
it was
one of the best things of the year so far for me. Did all of those songs originate from the same period of your life?
I really try to keep it relevant. So I didn't, you know, I mean, I've been writing songs for nearly 15 years, and I didn't want to be using teenage songs that I don't really relate to anymore.
Yeah,
but it's quite funny, because some of your old songs you'll go back to and realise that they now mean something else, and that you're getting something different from the song that you wrote about a separate subject altogether. That's rare.
Very interesting.
Yeah, very.
And you can see how other people can get different things out of your lyrics as well when that happens,
Exactly, yeah, you have the same experience. And but the songs on the album I wanted to keep fresh and keep relevant. So they're all, I think the oldest is maybe 2.5, 3 years old.
Right. The album is Eye to the Telescope. It is in the shops now. Katie Tunstall, thanks very much indeed. We had ordered some I Listen to the Beat leg warmers for you.
Oh.
And they haven't arrived yet, so we'll mail them on.
We'll mail them on and I shall sport them.
Right, thank you. Katie, you're going to do another track for us now. What will this one be?
I'm going to play Miniature Disasters. To wait my turn.
sucker gotta be hot and cold, gotta be tart and old, got to be good disco. To myself. Oh, miniature disasters, minor catastrophes, bring me to my knees. Well, I must be my own master, or a miniature disaster will be, oh, will be the death of me. I don't have to be underhand, I just gotta understand that it's gonna be up and down, it's going to be lost and found. Ooh. And I can't take to the sky before I like it on the ground. Discover how I need to behave, and I'll find out the answers when I know what to ask. But I speak a different language and everybody's talking too fast. Miniature disasters, minor catastrophes, bring me to my knees, yeah. Well, I must be my own master, or a miniature disaster will be. To run a little faster, or a miniature disaster will be. Oh, yes, I need to know I'll last if a little miniature disaster hits me. Oh, it will be the death of me.